Good evening, everyone. It's Dr. A. Vasquez. In this video, we will be discussing Walt's reckless containment theory. So what is it? Why is it relevant to criminal justice? So the containment theory states that crime is predicated on how many internal, external control mechanisms there are in place. So what does that mean? Internal, family, friends, community, right? Near and dear to individuals' heart. External, prisons, corrections, policing. So that is the containment theory, right? Certain levels of containment, if you will dictate, predicate, will affect, will manipulate, modify how crime and when crime is committed, right? The more containment layers there are, maybe crime will go down, right? And we see this, right? We see this with mandatory minimum sentencing. We see this with plea deals, plea bargains. We see this with judges that you're not supposed to play with. Maybe one jurisdiction is a little bit more stricter than others, right? So that is the containment theory. The containment theory states that crime is predicated on internal, external control mechanisms to the offender. Thank you.